is Tanya, and welcome back to the channel. Today I'm back with another speed build, and we're making an off-the-grid A-frame home. I already did something with like the new Laundry Day stuff pack, but I wanted to do another build today that kind of tested my building skills, and I really wanted to do a more like off-the-grid thing, so that's what we did. We don't have a washer and dryer in here, we just have a wash tub and the clothesline. We do have some electronics and like a fridge and stuff, but the roofs I use are like a more metal thing, and I'd imagine that they're made out of the same thing that solar panels are made out of. So this family, or this is really built for one sim or maybe a couple. They don't use a lot of electricity, but when they do have things to go ahead and use it, but it would be through their solar panel, everything solar powered. So there is like a very small TV, which I also imagine, since it's an old TV that has like the antenna on the top, that it could be maybe a radio powered TV or that like uses batteries. Like, I have all kinds of ideas for that. And we also have lots of gardening throughout this house and lots of plants. They're a very kind of eco-friendly family. I really wanted to use the original theme for Laundry Day stuff we had voted on, and it was eco-living, and then one of the ideas was off the grid, and I kind of just wanted to go for that. I also have never successfully made an A-frame house, and I thought this was the best time to do that. So I'm really, really happy with how it came out. So that is what we're building today. The bedroom ends up being upstairs. It's very, very small. The bed's against the wall because the person that has this home, it's really meant for them to be out in nature, and it's in Windenburg because I thought that was a nice countryside town. The only other place I thought it would look right maybe is Granite Falls, but I wanted it to be a house you could actually live in. You didn't have to go travel to go on vacation to. That's why we went ahead and put it in the countryside of Windenburg. So I don't know. I just really like this house. I had a lot of fun building it, and it ends up being brown paneling and stone on the outside, which I think makes a ton of sense for what it is. And we have a full garden. When you download it from the gallery, it'll have plants already growing there, already ready to harvest. I grabbed those off the gallery. I don't remember who put them up, but if you search the gallery for plants, people upload plants that are already made, and you can even get like cow plants and death flowers and stuff there if you don't want to go ahead and find them or wait for something to grow on yourself. So or by yourself on your own. That's what I meant. grow things on your own. So it's very convenient. I just thought if you guys downloaded this house, it's meant to be very, like the person that lives here would be very into nature. So I thought it would be nice to go ahead and have some of that greenery already growing here. So plenty of vegetables in the backyard. I think they're just potatoes and tomatoes. Potatoes and tomatoes. It's a tomato or tomato, potato or potato. So the funny ones are in the backyard. We had a little chimney up here because there was a little bit of weird bits of the roof, but I thought that would make sense. So we included that. I thought it looked kind of cute. And we have a lot of big windows that are from Parenthood throughout this. We have a couple of windows from Cats and Dogs as well. And I used a lot of stuff from Cats and Dogs because I think it works really well with this style, as does the Laundry Day back, which is kind of where the inspiration came from. So we're just putting a little half wall around this chimney here, and you know, adding some fences. I went back and forth about if these fences should even be here, what I wanted to do with it, and this house really evolved a lot throughout it, and I kept going back and adding more. I'm like, okay, I'm done. Oh no, let's add this. Okay, I need to add a table here. Ooh, this wall needs more decorations. Ooh, I want to do it was like the build that never stops, which is hilarious because the last time I built on this lot was a house that I wouldn't stop adding things to it as well. It's something about 20 by 20 lots in Windenburg. I don't know what it is, but I go into so much more detail on smaller builds, which is really why I do more smaller builds. I do want to bring another big build to the channel sometime soon, so if there's any ideas you guys have for that, because the last thing I did was a New England mansion, and that was right when Cats and Dogs came out. So that's something that'll take a little while if I do another really big build. But if you guys have any ideas of certain things you'd like to see me build, please let me know, because I'd be more than happy to take some of those suggestions and potentially incorporate them. I tend to like get ideas and like put a little spin on it and figure out what I want to do, which is really cool. So yeah, but today, eco-friendly, A-frame, off-the-grid home. And if you guys want to download this, it will be on the Sims 4 gallery if you search Griffey or the hashtag Miss Griffey. That information is always in the description down below if you'd like to go ahead and check it out. I believe it's like 47,000 simoleons, so it's not that affordable, but I mean, if you're trying to be more environmentally friendly your Sims are, I think they're willing to pay a little bit more money to go ahead and do that. So I think it's a decent price. We added this new planter from Laundry Day stuff. I think it's so cute. We added a lot of cute plants and stuff around that I don't normally use, and we added this rug outside all shrunk down and cute and things. It's a really weird floor plan at work first. I was like, how am I gonna fit a bedroom, a bathroom, a kitchen, a dining area, and a living room in here? And of course we don't have a separate dining room, it's just kind of a table in the kitchen, but we were able to make it work, and I'm very, very happy with how it came out. Here we are placing down a door from Cats and Dogs because just love it, and I thought it came out really well. It was a really good way to go ahead and fit that in. And we're just sectioning off here where the kitchen and dining room is going to be. And the living room. The living room is where those rugs are because I thought half wall would be a good way. And I struggle with this kitchen and I go back and forth and I just ignore it for a while and then I come back at the very end because I hated it for the longest time. But I think we fixed it in the end. But I left all the footage in for the kitchen so you guys could see the struggle. Some of the stuff I cut out, like when it was taking me a really long time to do stuff, or a little bit of the landscaping, but most of the landscaping I kept in. Tried to keep it as full as possible, but when I'm just like searching through the catalog and can't find something, I'll stop recording for a little while until I find what I'm looking for because I don't think just seeing that like rapidly scroll is that fun of an idea. But I don't know. Do you guys want to see me? You guys ever want to see live building? I do live stream here on YouTube and on other platforms as well. All that information is always in the description as well. So actually at the time of recording this, I'm live streaming in like an hour and a half. So I'm kind of on a crunch because I have a bunch of stuff to record today and a little stressed about it. But when you're seeing this, I won't be live streaming soon because this will come out on Friday. Yes, this is Friday today. So I'm not streaming today, but I will be tomorrow. So there you go. So hopefully you guys can make a live stream at some point in time. You'll get to see me like building live. I ask for suggestions, I take ideas. It's a really collaborative, fun time to like just chat with you guys and build some cool stuff because we mostly do builds. I occasionally do gameplay, but majority of the time we do lots of builds in the game because it's a really fun time. It's my favorite. It's my favorite thing to stream is building. It's also one of my favorite things to do in game, which is interesting because I used to be so much more of a game player, but I guess I am still. I mean, I have three Let's Plays, so I do a lot of gameplay too. But I just love my I like I love building. It's so much fun, and I don't know if I'd get annoyed like playing in this house or not. But I had so much fun building it that I don't care. It's just cute, and we're gonna change this kitchen a thousand times. You can see I'm still struggling on it. Hopefully, pretty soon we're gonna be abandoning it. Yep, we're going into the living room here, and we're gonna place down this little thing that we're gonna put a small TV on. Not that one, the one with the wire, not the wires, the antenna on top. Like I said, it could be potentially battery powered for like through a radio signal for emergencies, or things in this house just could be powered through the solar panel roof, but they try to keep their usage to a minimum, but they do have that option if they want it. That's kind of like I said, the idea I was going for here, because I didn't want to build like a really cute A-frame house and it didn't have a fridge. It didn't have a TV. Like it didn't have anything. I wanted it to like be mostly these people enjoy nature and are outdoorsy, but wanted a little bit of indoor luxuries as well, but very small. Like they're very, I don't know. A very humble family. I think it would be a kind of fun to live here, like to make those Sims anyway. I don't know if I'd get so frustrated with how small the home is, but I like tiny homes. I think it's kind of cool. But I don't know. I feel like it'd be a really interesting time. Let me know if what kind of houses you prefer to live in the Sims. Do you like average family homes, large family homes, tiny homes, mansions? Like I tend to just have like medium-sized family homes slash sort of small ones, but not like tiny houses. I like to build them, but I don't typically play in them. But I know everyone has a different play style, so I'm curious like who plays in tiny homes and if you've ever played in one of the houses I've built. Because I know a lot of you guys watch these videos and you comment, "Oh my god, I love this! Can I like I need to download this on some of the builds?" And I'm super duper flattered. I'm just really curious like if anyone's been playing in them, if you have any screenshots. Like I'd love to see that. Because I love these houses so much, and I tend to not have time to make families and play in them because most of my gameplay I do is either on stream or for my Let's Plays because I work full time, so like I haven't had time to play off camera in a long time. I'm hoping sometime soon I'll be able to do that, but at the same time, if I'm playing, I feel like I should be recording it. I don't know. Like, I gotta get back to one of my current households. I think I'll probably end up making a new one when I do decide to go ahead and do another family off camera. And I'll probably like be like, this is so and so, and make like a current household video because that's just how I am. But maybe that'll get me to actually play off camera sometime so I can enjoy the gameplay and then update you guys occasionally. Let me know if you guys would like to see that. See, now I stopped talking about the build. I did really good in the beginning because I realized last time I did a build that I didn't talk about it like pretty much at all. So I was like, today I'm gonna talk about the build. And yeah. I haven't been as much as I'd like to, but we added this little trellis above the upstairs balcony, which I think looks really, really cute. I'm pretty happy with that, and so much greenery on the roof. It's just greenery growing on the roof. I don't know. I liked the idea of it. It looks cute. So we went with it. Hopefully, you guys like it too. We also, I was experimenting with adding like a half wall here. We make it taller and kind of make it like a planter, sort of, and we have a bush in there because I needed a place to hang gardening accessories and like the hose. So we end up making this like a little planter, which I think is quite cool, and take one of those bushes and raise it up in there so it just looks like a planter, even though it's not. So if you download this house, you're going to want to make sure you go ahead and put on move objects before you place it. Otherwise, it's going to be kind of frustrating because things will drop anything that's been raised up through move objects. That goes for any of my builds. If you ever download anything, you're going to want to use the move objects cheat before placing it, which is bb.moveobjectson, and you can go ahead and open the cheat menu by doing Control Shift C to go ahead and access that and type that in. Because I use that quite a lot in my builds. Upstairs, we have a classic blue room because Tanya can't stop using blue, so I had to include that somewhere. And we have a table that has a small TV up here as well, so they can enjoy a little bit of television in bed. I thought that would just be nice. I really like this. It's a very quaint home. I know I wanted this to be like a home they can actually live in. That's why I built it here instead of Granite Falls. But in real life, I feel like I'd like to go here for a vacation. I don't think I could live in a place like this, but I think it would be a really fun place to go for a mini vacation. And here you are with all the plants. All the plants have been placed. I did that off camera because it took a while. And I have like two planters full of like catnip and stuff, but I ended up deleting those in the end because I didn't think they looked as good. But you have all of the tomatoes and tomatoes and potatoes that you could ever want. The tomatoes and potatoes. Yes. So they do a lot of gardening here. And of course, you can get rid of all those plants and plant whatever you want there. It's just a nice garden space for your Sims to go ahead and utilize in the backyard of this home. And this is the bathroom. It's pretty simple. We do change it up a little bit, and we make sure to have two laundry baskets in here because I'm like, oh my god, we have all the laundry stuff outside, but we don't have baskets for the clothes to collect in. So I went ahead and put one in the bathroom and one in the bedroom upstairs so that that whole system will be able to be used. And of course, if you don't want to use the laundry system, but you want to download this house or any house that includes laundry items, you can go ahead and just delete the all of the laundry stuff, and it won't work anymore. You won't have to do laundry, which I think is the best way they could do it because it makes it just so non-intrusive. I don't know if that's the right word, but you don't have to do it, which I think is the beauty of having it in the game because it's an option you have, which is what we had in The Sims 3 as well. You could choose to do it, or you could just not put it in your lot, and then it doesn't affect you at all, which I don't know, just like it. I think it's a little bit of fun. Because I feel like it could get annoying after a while, but at the same time, I kind of like them having like a chore they have to do all the time, because they don't really have something like that currently in The Sims. Like, if something breaks, yeah, you gotta fix it, or you gotta clean up the dishes or whatever, but like, it's something else. Like, it's just something that continuously happens. Whereas with dishes, to an extent, like, your Sims don't have to do it. You can just drag the dishes into the sink. Whereas the laundry, you have to have your Sim do it. I mean, if they leave clothes on the floor, you can drag those into a hamper, I'm pretty sure, but I haven't experienced that yet because I think only slobs and lazy Sims leave clothes on the floor. Everyone else puts things in the hamper. So yeah, I don't know. It's more of a thing your Sims are doing than something you can like manage on your own. So I think that's why I like it so much. But we're fixing up the kitchen in here. It took me ages to get to this point because I was just not happy with this kitchen, but I'm pretty happy with how it ended up turning out in the end. We're gonna move some stuff again. We put this little table here. I was just making sure it wasn't showing through the wall. And we have just some clutter on it, a bucket and some baskets and stuff. A bunch of stuff from laundry day, basically. Just clutter that was organized. We also swapped out this table that the TV was on for one from laundry day stuff as well, because I really like it and haven't gotten to use it yet. So I thought it would fit in quite well here because we wanted something that was very narrow to go ahead and put there, because we don't have a lot of space in this house for a TV setup anyway. So here we are adding that table and all the stuff on it. We added the wreath to the front door. I don't know why I always say it wrong. So I thought that looked kind of cute. Of course, when you open the door, it's going to be floating there. So if that bothers you, you can go ahead and delete that. But I think it's pretty cute. I'm pretty happy with it. We also added a whole bunch of clutter to this corner cabinet over here. And I'm just noticing the cabinet, not the cabinet, the counter is like on an angle. I wonder if I fix that. I feel like I probably have to, but I might not have. I hope I did. If I didn't, I am so sorry for that. But anyway, we're adding all of this clutter over here, which I think is quite... Ooh, I'm moving it. Oh, I think I fixed it. I fixed it, guys. I'm proud of myself for doing that. And just adding a rug in here, and I think that looks pretty cute. And the table, and I think that's pretty much it. So we're in screenshots now. I did not time that right. I hope you guys enjoyed this speed build, and like and subscribe if you haven't already. I'd love to have you along for this journey on YouTube. Anyway, bye guys.